Hey guys, welcome back to my project. In this video, we will add features to the hardware created in the previous project. The first thing we need to do is to output the image that came from the ESP32CAM on the screen. Let's see how I edit this. First, what I will do is adding the ESP32CAM code. I'm pretty sure you have the example source code if you've installed the Arduino core for the ESP32. Please install it if you don't have it yet. You need this for any ESP32 project in Arduino IDE. Okay, go to the file, examples, ESP32, camera, camera web server. This has all code for the getting frame images from the OV2640 module. To minimize my code, I will bring the only necessary part of this example. It's gonna be short. We need this ESP camera header file. It has a call function to get the image with JPEG format from the module. Instead of adding the camera pin header file, I directly define the pins. Typically, ESP32CAM defines the pins connected to AI Thinker module. So just bring the old pins under the AI Thinker to your project. The next is adding the camera initialization part. I'm gonna make a function to do it. Copy the configuration of the camera. The output image is 320 by 240 QVGA. The JPEG quality has a value from 0 to 63 and the raw number means higher quality. Set the frame buffer, which is 2 to set ITS runs in continuous mode. This only works in JPEG format. And initialize the ESP camera with the current config. Don't forget to call this function in the setup. The camera is now ready to use. Let's create a function to get images from the camera module. Obtaining one frame buffer, which is a pointer structure from ESP camera fvget function. We can refer to pixel data, buffer length, width height format, and the timestamp from this pointer structure. If the frame buffer is NAR or NAR JPEG format, we can output on the screen, so we do nothing in this case. Otherwise, we can print it out on the screen. Just printing a text on the console because no display is currently set. Returns the used frame buffer. If we don't do this, a memory overflow will occur. Let me call this function from the loop. Xclock is a clock signal used to drive the entire sensor chip and is a signal input to the OV2640 from outside. The default is 20 MHz, but it works faster at 10 MHz. Unfortunately, it doesn't really help for now because we have bottlenecks in the interface. Okay, I think it looks good. Let me build and check the result on the serial monitor. I will show you my basic settings. You just have to choose a huge app on the partition scheme. Now it's unloading. Checking with the text because there is no display yet. I checked that everything from the camera setting to JPG image is normal. If you had any problems, you wouldn't have been able to see this text. From now on, let's set up the display. Two libraries are required here. It's TFT ESPi and TJPEG decoder. If you haven't installed it yet or it's an old version, please install a new version. In order to use TFT ESPi, you need to set it up according to the display you are using. Go to Arduino libraries folder, TFT ESPi, open the user setup header file. Scroll down to select the display driver IC currently in use. I use ILI9488, so except for this, comment out the others. The following are the pin settings. Scroll down, the node MCU is set by default. This is not the board we use, so comment out it all. You can now see the ESP32. Here we enter the pin number we are using. Finally, set the SPI frequency to 40 MHz. My display will cause problem if it's more than that. The TFT ESPi user setup setting with this is done. Don't forget to save it before closing it. We need to add the header files required to drive the display. SPI, TFT ESPi, and TJPEG decoder. Let's make it a global variable so that TFT can be accessed from anywhere. I will create a callback function that we need to draw a JPEG image on the screen. It's just to push the image to the screen with bitmap type. This is how the TJPEG decoder works. Let's create a function that initializes the display. After beginning the TFT, set the display orientation. 1 and 3 are in landscape mode and 0 and 2 are in portrait mode. I will use white as the background color on the screen. The following is TJPEG decoder setup. This works based on TFT ESPi, so all we have to do is just set it up. The scale of the JPEG is 1. You can zoom in with the integer number. The swipe byte true means the SPI buffer can be used. Lastly, specify TFT output as the callback function. It's done the display initialization part. Go to the showing image function and output the JPEG image obtained from the camera on the screen through the TJPEG decoder. As a parameter, they are storing coordinate XY, buffer, and length of the buffer. Don't forget the display initialization function and edit it to the setup. Let me build first to check all fine. Oh, there is a typo. It should be JPG, not a JPEG. Okay, all good. It's time to build and upload it. Let's see the result. You can see the normal text output as before. Let me show you my current toy camera screen. Here you are. You can change the starting coordinates of the image as you want, and also you can change the direction of the display, and also you can create a separate camera by pressing the ESP30cam the same way the display looks. That's all for today's video. We will continue to upgrade. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.